if you want to find out how quickly the society can turn against one, and I'm talking seriously here, stand up and tell the truth about just anything that you want to stand up and tell the truth about. It scares the living daylights out of everyone. And so the first thing that happens is you find out who your friends are and who your friends are not, because there's a great weeding out there. And it's not anything that you do on your part or that I've done on my part. They just disappear. And you find very quickly that people are afraid to be around you because they can see the government being upset about what you're talking about. And they can see repercussions coming, and of course they have happened and will continue to happen. And ultimately, I really believe that there will be some kind of a terminal point where they decide that they're not just not going to put up with this pest anymore, and that's going to be the end of me. We have been literally financially in the ditch. We have found it impossible to get any kind of a normal job with anyone who knows anything about what I do. It's you can't go to church, you can't go to cocktail parties because everybody else is sitting around talking about the weather or, oh, what school did you go to? And when you have done the research and arrived at some of the answers that I know to be true now, those people become like kindergarten children. They're not in the real world, and I can't engage in that kind of a conversation. So you really find yourself in another world that has nothing to do with all of the rest of the people who are running around engaged in their activities that they think are so important to them. And to them, they really are. But to me, they've lost the reality of what really is important, and they're about to lose their freedom to even discover those things at this point.
I'll ask you a last question, and that is, how would you like to be seen or remembered in future years when people look back and you think about the thrust of your work? What is it that you would like to be best remembered for?
I think I would like to be remembered like Paul Revere was remembered. At a time when it was needed and nobody else would do it, I got on my horse and rode through the night and said, "The British are coming." That's all. I'm not looking for any fame or any fortune. You certainly don't get rich doing what I'm doing. And infamous is probably the real word that describes what happens to you as far as public recognition in a world where political correctness is the theme of the day. You just don't do what I'm doing. So if anybody wants to remember me, I would certainly be pleased if they just remembered I did what was the responsible and the right thing to do at a time when nobody else had the guts to do it.
We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.